Hey guys, so this was a while back, maybe like 2 years back. I was swimming, right? I'm not a big swimmer, but I was swimming, and we've got this beautiful Lido outdoor swimming pool. And not we, as in me and my family, as in the town I live in. And I was, you know, doing my thing, swimming, got dressed, got out of the pool, and then outside of the swimming pool, a chap came up to me and said, "Hey, I was swimming next to you in the swimming pool, and I couldn't help but notice that you were swimming much faster than me, and you were moving way less." He said, "I was thrashing about trying to get as fast as you were, but I couldn't do it." And this isn't like a gloat. I'm not by any means a good swimmer or a fast swimmer. I guess maybe I was just doing well that day. And he said to me, "How do you do it? What's your trick?" And I said to him, "I don't know, maybe just swim less, glide more." And I said that, and he said to me, "Well, that sounds like good life advice." And I thought, actually, that's really good life advice. I'm gonna keep that in my pocket. And that's been back in my mind for obviously a couple of years now. But I thought about it today and I was like, actually, it is great advice for you as it is for me. Swim less, glide more. Now what that's, you know, you could put that down to the 80-20 principle or the trim the fat. What are you doing in your process, your creative process, that is creating resistance? Usually this comes down to workflow, okay? Usually it comes down to you sat at your door and you not having a template, or you not having presets saved so that you have extra time wasted every single time you write finding the sounds. It could be the fact that you spend way too much time fiddling with your knobs in your synths. You know, sometimes that is a wonderfully freeing and creative process in and of itself, but this is why you save presets, so that you create your own presets. But if you're in the creative act of writing and you're not doing sound design, this is very important there, because obviously if you're doing sound design, that is part of the process. But if you're doing just trying to write a track as a composer, complete track, spend less time fiddling on the details and more time going on the maximal output, you know, the macro, okay? You want to think out large, so you go, okay, well, I want a synth bass. Don't spend an hour fiddling around with Omnisphere, whatever synth bass it is you want to use. Spend a minute finding a sound that's close and use that. And just write the thing. You can go back in afterwards later and do that, because what you're doing there is you're swimming less, you're putting less energy into the kind of small details, and you're gliding more. You are letting the process run, and that's the really important part. The other thing, of course, is not getting bogged down too much on the details of your progressions development. Because at the root of every piece of music, you can go, this chord progression continues. Boom. Here's another chord progression. You've just got blocks. You are block writing. Everybody block writes to some extent. You're taking your blocks and just put them in there and get the track written. Work on the details later when you're going back in to edit the idea. You know, get the basics, get the progression, get the melody, get the rhythms, and maybe a few different textures, different builds. Get that out, because then you have a complete track, and then you feel like you've achieved something. You get that lovely boost of positive hormones, of good energy, whatever you want to call it, and then that gives you the impetus to carry on. It's too many times have I wasted my time, many times, trying to get my intro, my act one, the first 30 seconds, perfect. And it creates a problem. It creates resistance. Because then what I do is I create a perfect act one, and act two then needs to feel that much bigger. Act three needs to feel even bigger. So I get all panicky, and then I would just leave it and start another act one. So now my process is pretty much always block out the whole track. block it out. Because then it removes the pressure. And what you're doing there, it removes the resistance to the compositional process. You are putting less effort in for more gains. You are swimming less, you are gliding more, you are resisting less, you are flowing more. Okay? It's so vital that you do this and you practice this and have fun with it. Find spots in your workflow, in your composition process, in your daily life where you're resisting. You know, they talk about habit forming being something that can be done and prevented and stopped, you know, whatever, created and destroyed with the simple act of the presence of a trigger. So you want to read more? Leave books out. Simple trigger increases your chance of successful habit forming. And it's the same with this. You remove the resistance, it increases your chances of successfully habitualizing completing tracks. It works like a charm.